They may be new to the United States.
We have them from all seven continents.
But they are no foreigners to the U.S. justice system. For an increasing number of immigrants, legal and illegal, the land of opportunity has taken on a whole new meaning. These people spend their time,
most of the crimes are drug related,
and your money in jail for crimes they have committed after crossing into the U.S. In Texas alone last year, more than 12,000 such aliens were in custody at the average jail cost of $40 a day. Locking up that group for their crimes for just 1 year costs taxpayers more than $180 million. Still, jail administrators insist the expense is a necessary evil.
They need to know that there's more than just throw you back on the bus and take you back to the border. They need to understand that if you come into this country, you commit a crime, you're going to go to jail. They are treated as though they're just another criminal.
And like any other criminal, foreign inmates get room and board, rest and relaxation, and full medical treatment. For some, it's a home away from home.
Lift weights, go play basketball. They like to stay in jail.
Not so, though, for Mexican national Jose Flores Romero. His recent experiences with the U.S. justice system made a strong impression.
I told him, send me back to my country, Mexico.
But once they are freed from jail, criminal aliens are not necessarily free to go. In immigration courtrooms like this one, many will be ordered to leave this country, even though you and they have paid for their crimes. But even after their deportation is ordered,
6 months for nothing,
criminal aliens must still make one more time-consuming and costly layover on the long journey home.